Welcome back, my friend. So here we are again. We're going to watch another Kurzgesagt video. Before we do, if you're new around here, you should come check out the thing that I've been building for a while now. It's called CalVPN. It's the first post-quantum VPN. It can actually protect you from quantum computers. If you don't believe me, come have a read on the website. Do your research on post-quantum cryptography. This is a brand new thing that is going to be incredibly important in our digital world. And we have the first post-quantum VPN you guys can use, and you can actually use it for free right now. We have a free alpha out. Only on Windows, but yeah, come follow the journey. So me and a few friends have been building this. We knew we could do it. We've utilized open source, of course, and yeah, we've made it happen. So come test it for us. We need a lot of testing done. I can't wait to share more with you guys. I forgot to mention, I am just house sitting at the moment, so this background is temporary. Unfortunately, it's very beautiful. Check this out. I just worked this out the other day. Oh, look at that. I look like a real YouTuber now. The most dangerous stuff in the universe. So obviously I'll let you know what I think is the most dangerous stuff in the universe, but you'll have to stay tuned. Right? So let's watch.
Neutron stars are the densest things that are not black holes.
Obviously, Kurzgesagt has never met my manager.
In their cores, we might find the most dangerous substance in existence. Strange matter. A bizarre thing so extreme that it bends the rules of the universe and could infect and destroy everything it comes into contact with. Or it could teach us about how the universe began. Maybe both.
I'm gonna have to straight off the gate disagree with Kurzgesagt here. I don't think that's the most dangerous stuff in the universe. But anyway, I'm going to hear him out. I'm going to listen to what he has to say. And then I'm going to tell you what really is the most dangerous stuff in the universe.
To understand how extreme strange matter really is, we first need to get a few basics. What is an...
Oh, we have some sexy math. That is some very sexy math. Quack, quack, yes. Well, if it quacks like a duck. But anyway, let's keep going.
Neutron star. And how does strange matter break the rules of the universe? To get all of this into one video, we'll grossly oversimplify a few things, but we'll provide you with further reading if you want more details. A neutron star is what remains after a very massive star explodes in a supernova. When this happens, the star's core collapses under its own gravity with such a strong inward force that it squeezes nuclei and particles together violently. Electrons are pushed into protons, so they merge and turn into neutrons. All the nothing inside of atoms is suddenly completely filled with particles that really don't want to be close to each other, but have no choice. They desperately...
Me too particles. Me too.
...they push back against gravity, against the collapse. If gravity wins, they will become a black hole. If they win, they become a neutron star. This makes neutron stars like giant atomic nuclei the size of a city, but holding the mass of our sun. And here, things get weird. The environment in the core of neutron stars is so extreme that the rules of nuclear physics change. And this could lead to a strange and extremely dangerous substance. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. We first need to know the rules before we learn how they can be broken. Protons and neutrons, the particles making up the nuclei of atoms, are made up of smaller particles called quarks. Quarks really don't want to be alone. They are what we call confined. You can try to separate them, but the harder you pull, the harder they try to pull themselves back together. If you use a lot of energy, they just use this energy to create new quarks. Quarks only exist together as the building blocks of other particles and have never been observed by themselves. They come in many types, but only two appear to make stable matter. The up and down quarks found in protons and neutrons. All other quarks seem to decay away quickly. But this may be different inside neutron stars. The forces operating in their cores are so extreme that they are actually similar to the universe shortly after the Big Bang. Neutron star cores are like fossils, which can let us peer back in time to the beginning of everything. So learning how quarks behave inside a neutron star is a way of understanding the very nature of the universe itself. One hypothesis is that inside a neutron star core, protons and neutrons deconfine. All the particles crammed shoulder to shoulder dissolve and melt into a sort of bath of quarks. Uncountable numbers of particles become one giant thing made purely from quarks. Quark matter. A star made from this is called a quark star, though from the outside it may not look any different than a regular neutron star. Now,
theoretical objects.
We can finally talk about the most dangerous substance. If the pressure inside a quark star is great enough, it may get stranger. Literally. In the cores of neutron stars, some of the quarks may be converted into strange quarks. Strange quarks have bizarre nuclear properties, and they are heavier and, for the lack of a better word, stronger. If they turn up, they could create strange matter. Strange matter might be the ideal state of matter. Perfectly dense, perfectly stable, indestructible. More stable than any other matter in the universe. So stable that it can exist outside neutron stars. If this is the case, we have a problem. It might be infectious. Every piece of matter it touches might be so impressed by its stability that it would immediately turn it into strange matter too. Protons and neutrons would dissolve and become part of the quark bath, which frees energy and creates more strange matter. The only way to get rid of it would be to throw it into a black hole. But then again, who cares? All of it is inside neutron stars. Except when neutron stars collide with other neutron stars, or black holes, they spew out tremendous amounts of their insides, some of which could include little droplets of strange matter.
You know, that's where we actually think a lot of gold comes from. Neutron star collisions. You probably know that a lot of the stuff we're made of, all the heavy elements, at least actually come from exploded stars. And some of the particularly heavy stuff we think may have come, most of it at least, from, you know, colliding neutron stars.
Are as dense as the core of a neutron star. They could be really small, maybe even subatomic, but even the largest strangelets wouldn't be any bigger than a rocket. These strangelets would drift through the galaxy for millions or billions of years until they meet a star or planet by chance. If one were to strike Earth, it would immediately start converting it into strange matter. The more it converts, the more it would grow. Ultimately, all of the atoms making up Earth would be converted. Earth would be...
That reminds me of that recent Rick and Morty episode. I can't remember the thing's name where it bites everything. They should have played on this with that for sure.
...come a hot clump of strange matter the size of an asteroid. If a strangelet strikes the sun, it would collapse into a strange star, eating through it like fire through a dry forest. This would not change the sun's mass much, but it would become way less bright, so Earth would freeze to death. And like a tiny virus, we'd have no way to see a strangelet coming. Worse still, some theories suggest strangelets are more than common, outnumbering all stars in the galaxy. These strangelets could have formed very early after the Big Bang, when it was as hot and dense as a neutron star core everywhere. They might be clumping around the gravity of galaxies as the universe expanded and evolved. Strangelets could even be so numerous and massive that they might actually be the dark matter we suspect holds galaxies together. But then again, maybe not. This is speculation, and the Earth and Sun and planets haven't been consumed in a wildfire of strangelets in the past few billion years, so the odds seem good that it won't happen anytime soon. Understanding these strange objects today may be the key to understanding the birth of our universe and why it grew to look the way it does now. When scientists first started playing with magnets and wires and thinking about electrons, they had no idea how technology would evolve in the next 100 years. The scientists thinking about the cause of neutron stars and strange matter today may be setting up humans for a future beyond our wildest imaginations. Or maybe not. Time will tell.
So that was a nice try by Kurzgesagt, but let me tell you what the actual most dangerous stuff in the universe is. I mean, if you had called it the most strange stuff in the universe, that would have been okay in my book. It would have been partly correct. Not the most dangerous, though. And like, if I'm going to just give you the straight answer before I tell you this thing I wanted to talk about, you'd probably have to say gravity or time, right? But let me tell you about something at least more dangerous than these damn strange stars, all right? They're called, drum roll please, naked singularities. That's right. You definitely don't want to get strange matter and naked singularities together in a bar, Because who knows what'll happen? Because of something called cosmic censorship, the cosmic censorship hypothesis, at least, we might not be able to find these things in nature. But, you know, I'm all for that free energy, that free matter, if you will. I think they could be out there. A lot of physicists do. All of that theoretical physics mumbo jumbo, get that out of here. Anything goes in that land. And so let's talk about these naked singularities and what I think might just be the most epic way to die. That's getting butt naked and diving into a naked singularity. That's poetic, man. You know, like, just that would be that's my swan song. If I ever write a book, that's how my main character's going. So yeah, those strange stars, look, they're pretty dangerous. Don't get me wrong. But these naked singularities, wow. These things would, you know, they could be causing the laws of physics to fall apart themselves, wherever they roam, these monsters. So if you're not familiar with these naked singularities, you can kind of think of them as like a black hole that's been turned inside out. So, you know, the centers of black holes, we think there are things called singularities. This is theoretical, things of infinite density, these singularities, right? Now, all a naked singularity is you know, that singularity without the event horizon. That's what you would essentially call a naked singularity, okay? So it's like that naked entity, this thing that kind of breaks physics, just being exposed to, you know, the rest of space-time. Currently, as we understand them, they can only be hidden behind these event horizons, all right? You know, allowing them to just roam around naked, well, that causes a big fuss in the universe. And, you know, the physics police have been like, no naked entities in the universe. You know, they have to hide themselves. And so that's where this cosmic censorship hypothesis, you know, was enforced. If these things exist, these naked bad boys, it would be like an abrupt hole in the fabric of reality, right? And it wouldn't just distort space-time. It would wreak havoc on the laws of physics themselves, wherever it goes, and lead to like a complete catastrophic loss of predictability. And then someone's going to have to explain why general relativity, you know, which is meant to be universal, doesn't explain what's going on here. You can all take a chill pill, you can all relax and rest easy, because no one's actually been able to prove that these things can exist just yet. And we've never found them. Which is great, because, you know, black holes are bad enough company as it is. Now, black holes are cool. I'm glad they're around. So if you want to know how one of these naked singularities would behave, well, unpredictable is your answer. And that's kind of the whole point. So it's really important to realize here, though, like, we really don't know if cosmic censorship is true or false. And we really don't even know how to clearly state it rigorously. There's actually serious suggestions that just gravitational collapse could result in the formation of naked singularity. So by definition, a singularity is just a situation you get when geodesics are incomplete. Go look up what those are. So for example, if a ray of light hits a singularity, by definition, we can't use general relativity to trace the ray through the singularity and see where it goes when it emerges. More generally, a naked singularity, like in general, can emit arbitrary information and unlimited energy, at least in geo. What would you see if you were to look at a naked singularity? Well, you know, stop looking, pervert. Another really cool thing about them is that the gravitational pull of these things, these singularities, is infinitely strong. That means that things could actually, you know, be pulled towards them faster than the speed of light. Why? Because, you know, you might have heard, to travel at the speed of light, you'd need to, you know, approach infinite energy. Well, guess what? These things have infinite energy. Physics just really falls apart when it comes to these things. So we probably shouldn't trust anything that we can kind of tell about them with current theories. So like if a black hole is spinning, right, it can form a second event horizon nestled inside the first. And the faster the black hole spins, the closer these event horizons actually get to each other. And if it spins fast enough, the mathematics predicts that the event horizons can actually like cancel out. And of course the actual physics is much more complicated, but you get the idea, right? And that would reveal the naked singularity and just wreak havoc on the universe. And just all predictability is gone at that point. So far, we haven't actually found any black holes spinning fast enough to, you know, expose their singularities. We don't actually have a way of determining if a random astrophysical object is just a regular old black hole or a naked singularity.
you know, with the exception of, you know, the images provided by the Event Horizon Telescope. We don't have a whole lot of pictures like those, though. These naked singularities could be an amazing way to test quantum gravity theories like string theory. Only problem is, you know, these theories of ours currently of quantum gravity don't have much skin in the game. They don't exactly give us many predictions, even of these things. So it's really down to the observers to just find these things and have a look, have a look-see, have a perv. I think we should be looking for these naked singularities instead of, you know, trying to find reasons why they can't exist, because it could be a path for exploring completely new physics, right? But, you know, there is a crucial unknown. You know, what does a naked singularity look like? Very tempted to just get naked right now as a joke. No, I'm not doing that. But anyway, I think we'll leave it there with that bombshell. So hopefully this video didn't put you to sleep as much as it did my dog. He was very happy before I started talking about physics. Before you go anywhere, you have to hit some time derivative of momentum onto that subscribe button, and then go download KelVPN, have a play with it for free, because that would mean a lot to me. I'll catch you guys next time.